From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening. Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We are learning more tonight about the man from Dexter who police say shot and killed his wife and their two children before taking his own life. Prosecutors say 37-year-old Stephen Lake kept a holstered handgun on his bedpost. He also threatened to take a knife to his wife, 38-year-old Amy Lake. Police found the Lakes, along with their two children, 12-year-old Monica and 13-year-old Cody, shot to death yesterday at Amy Lake's home in Dexter. The district attorney says Lake was going to trial next month, accused of threatening his wife and his children and holding them hostage 1 year ago today. An investigation is underway about a possible delay in last week's murder-suicide in Winslow. Investigators say officers were delayed several minutes in responding to Sarah Gordon's 911 call just moments before her husband killed her. Police say the dispatcher who took the call misunderstood the street name and sent officers to the wrong address. Soon after the phone call, Nathaniel Gordon killed his wife outside of their home and then later killed himself while being chased by police. A Sabattis man accused of attacking and stabbing his girlfriend pleaded not guilty today to a charge of attempted murder. Prosecutors say Leon Hinckley stabbed his girlfriend while driving in Lisbon last February. Police say Hinckley then drove to his parents' home with his 13-month-old child in the car and ran into the woods where police captured him. He is held tonight on $100,000 bail and is ordered to have no contact with his former girlfriend. Lincoln County Sheriff's officers are looking for a man from Booth Bay they say is wanted for sexually assaulting two teenage girls. 35-year-old Kenneth Dobson is wanted on charges of gross sexual assault. Investigators say he may be staying in empty buildings or wooded areas. Anyone with any information is asked to contact the Lincoln County Sheriff's Office. Scarborough police are looking for help in finding a gray sedan involved in a hit and run that hurt a woman this morning on Payne Road. Police say a woman driving the sedan crossed the center line while heading south near Flaherty Farm and hit a woman who was outside of her vehicle. Investigators say the sedan's driver did not stop and was last seen heading toward the Dunston intersection. Police say the woman who was hit suffered minor injuries. Of our history buffs, it's an almost realistic look at how Christopher Columbus crossed the Atlantic more than 500 years ago. Replicas of the Nina and Pinta will spend the next 2 weeks in Maine, opening today for the public in Kittery. While historically the larger Pinta is said to have some flaws, the 65-foot handmade Nina is widely believed to be right on. But one of the first questions many people ask is, well, since Columbus actually had three ships, why are there only two? And what happened to the Santa Maria?
Columbus never liked her. She was a poor sailing boat to start with, never made it back to Spain. So historically, we really don't know that much about her other than the type of boat she was.
Well, the two replicas will remain docked at the Bader's Island Marina in Kittery through next Tuesday. Then they head for Southport Marine in South Portland. It'll be open there from Thursday, the 23rd through the 27th. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.